What's up, Cardboard GTS Nation? Live. We'll kick things off, as always, with our Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll, which is, Ivan?
Oh, it's a softball, but it's a perfect one for finals week, conference finals week. Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll. Who wins this year's NBA championship? So before you answer that question, go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive to vote in the poll. Also, we direct you there at the beginning of the show because guess what? We mentioned a couple of box breaks we're doing. Those aren't for us. We give away the hits from those to you. But we are on Twitch. We're on live stream. We're on YouTube. We're on Facebook. We're all these places. And so in order to aggregate winners, we have to use Twitter. So if you don't have a Twitter account, create one right now. It's free. Follow us, Go GTS Live. Vote in the poll question and then pay attention throughout the show when we do the giveaway tweets to enter as well. So it's the pinned tweet right at the top of our feed, twitter.com/GoGTSLive. And honestly, I'd say the results are surprising, even though you could argue it's a landslide, simply because it's not as much of a landslide as I expected. My vote was for, out of the four teams, Denver Nuggets, Miami Heat, Los Angeles Lakers, Boston Celtics. My vote was for the Los Angeles Lakers. Most of you voted for the Los Angeles Lakers, relatively speaking, 48.9%. So not a majority of you, though. Had the most votes, but not a majority. And I feel like they're just so far poised ahead of everybody else. I don't know. That's my thoughts. Who did you vote for, Rob, and why?
Well, I really didn't want to vote for the Lakers. But when I looked at the options, and if Miami were to beat Boston, all you got to do is shut down Jimmy Buckets, right? Boston has a couple of tools to go to, so I think Boston would give the Lakers a little bit more of a challenge. I don't honestly at this point give the Nuggets much of a chance yet, but man, they are a team on the come. But I think all in all, I think the Lakers have it all put together for this year. I'm going to get to weigh in on this too.
I just wanted to throw in real quick the odds. So the Lakers today jumped to -176 on the odds, which means that you have to bet $176 to win 100. Meanwhile, every other team is positive odds, with the Heat at +400, which means if you bet 100, you win 400. So that's how out of skewed the odds are right now with the Lakers likely to win according to the odds. James, you watch more basketball than either of us, probably both of us combined. Do you agree that if the Heat win, all they got to do is shut down Jimmy Buckets and the Lakers have it, or what's your take?
Yes, I guess. I picked the Lakers as well.
Did we lose James? Did
we lose me? We thought he was going to have.
No, sorry. I had our Skype chat muted. I'm actually talking in the show, but so I have to unmute two mics to talk.
Gotcha. Okay.
I picked the Lakers as well. They have the deepest team and the best players. Jimmy Butler has never played in the Eastern Conference Finals, and he always gets hurt. His nickname is General Soreness because he sits out a lot with that designation. I also don't like Jimmy Butler because he played for the Timberwolves and he had a very bad breakup with them. So I am rooting against the Heat, even though I like the rest of that team. Goran Dragic has been playing well, so has Bam Adebayo. Nuggets are a fun team, like you said, Rob, but I don't think they can beat the Lakers. And I mean, if you're like Ivan and you're part of the whole sports are rigged narrative, I think they want it to be
Boston.
Lakers.
Yeah, for sure. Right.
But I like Boston. They're a fun team.
Rebuilding of a whole new dynasty era potentially for both of those clubs. The NBA would love that for sure. All right. So you guys have plenty of time to weigh in on that. Let's see if we can skew this any which way. We'll check in with the poll later in the program as we wait for Emily to join us. What else has your interest in the hobby?
Oh, in the hobby? Oh, well, I don't want to step on anything that might be in hobby happenings, even though I'm famous for doing so. But I'm really stoked for Allen and Ginter, which is coming up. Always an eclectic checklist If collectors are a little newer to collecting, this is a baseball plus product. So lots of names that are outside of the baseball and the sports realm. You know, things are just exciting. I love being on Twitter and seeing collectors get packs, get boxes, rip stuff. The Ben Baller Chrome boxes have been hitting this week. I was blessed to get one from Ben as a friend. I paid him for it, but I still got it from Ben, so I got it a little bit faster. Lots of fun ripping those. Yeah, it's just it, full swing. Football's going, baseball's going, basketball's going, hockey's going. Tennis is going, Rob. What's not going right now?
Everything is going. Well, let's bring in Emily Kless, Marketing Communications Manager at Topps. Emily, it's been a while.
I'm so excited to be on. I hope you're doing well. And yeah, we have all the sports back. It's exciting.
It really, really is. And I'm showing off your Allen and Ginter card in one of the windows we have streaming right now that you sent to Ivan and I. That's really cool. Now, I know you mentioned that this was last year's Allen and Ginter card, but you got to explain the shirt to me.
Absolutely.
Big shark jaws. What's going on there?
So last year, I was lucky enough to be selected to be part of Allen and Ginter as part of our employee subset. And I saw that the product was going to be dropping on Shark Week, which is arguably the best week of television. So, yep, I had to break out the Jaws tee, and you know, I figured it'd be a good photo for a baseball card, and that's sweet of you guys to put it up. It's my thank you for having me join the show tonight.
Oh, it's absolutely our pleasure. I know. Since you've taken over the reins of Top social media and stuff, you brought some different aspects than we're used to. The Allen and Ginter campaign leading up to release, hats off, truly. You got really unique and creative with that. What was the inspiration for wanting to show off some of the subjects that are off the non-baseball roster?
Yeah, thank you. It's I'm not going to take credit. It's a huge team effort behind, you know, behind the scenes at Topps. So it's really, you know, big team effort, especially when it comes to Allen and Ginter, because there's so many moving pieces, right? You have baseball players, you have non-baseball players, and it's fun. And you know, anytime you ask someone what it's like to be on a baseball card, they have a good answer, always have a good answer. And so I was kind of inspired by our spring training. We went down this past February, which feels like years ago at this point. And we asked a lot of baseball players, you know, what was it like to see yourself on a Topps card for the first time? And so I thought that since it is a baseball product, we could kind of, you know, derive some inspiration from there and put some quotes that we had from the talent directly about what it's like to be on a Topps card. And there was some fun stuff that we wanted to show off and some stuff that we didn't show off, just to let, you know, our collectors look at the checklist and see what they could be excited about. You know, we held some cards back, but yeah, thank you. I'm glad you guys, you know, were following along. I think it was a fun way to, you know, tease out some of the subjects before the checklist dropped.
And what were some of those responses? Like, what were some of your favorite ones to read? Or were any of them, were you able to have any personal interaction, or was it all just via marketing forms?
Yeah, it was mostly via email. But, you know, I think one of the cool ones for me was Brianna Scurry. And, of course, you know, legend, women's national team, you know, soccer team legend, part of the, you know, U.S., the 99 team. And just it's cool to have her in the set, because you can be a, you know, such a professional at another sport, and then you're introduced into the world of baseball cards, and there's nothing like being on a baseball card. And so it's really cool to hear how some of, you know, the athletes, even, you know, like a Bucky Lasek, right? You know, pro skateboarder, and, you know, to hear him say it's an honor to be on a Topps card is a really cool thing. So while I love to have, you know, the pop culture icons in there, it's always kind of fun to have the different athletes in there, because baseball cards are king, right? Everyone loves being on a baseball card. So no matter, you know, what sport you play, it's still fun to see yourself on a trading card.
And not only limited to just sports too. I know that my kids were excited when I showed them a picture of Chip and Joanna from they watched the show, and they're going to kill me for not remembering it. You know, Flip That House, Home Improvement. I don't know. I mean, but they were bummed when that show went off the air, and still they DVR all the reruns, and they thought it was just so cool. And I saw a reply that he gave today on Twitter about being on a card, and it just is something to the effect like, you know, 10-year-old me is just geeked or something like that. So it is really neat to be able to share those experiences and the feeling that people get seeing themselves on a baseball card. Ivan and I do not yet have that privilege. I actually was thinking of trying to buy our way into Allen and Ginter next year. I don't know. You know,
I tried.
Clay Larosky just won't cut me a deal, you know, and Tom Fish always outbids me at the silent auction to do that. So I guess I'm SOL for now.
That's hilarious. Yeah, it's great. You know, everyone all of a sudden comes out of the woodworks campaigning, right? Which is fun. It's fun to see. I would do the same exact thing if I wasn't, you know, lucky enough to be in the product last year. But it's great. And then, you know, it's cool to see what other celebrities notice, you know, their fellow celebrities on baseball cards. And yeah, it's just it's a lot of fun, this product. It's kind of you know, it's almost like a breath of fresh air every time, you know, we open a box of Allen & Ginter, because it's wacky. You know, we never know what's going to be around any corner. And I think that's part of the fun of opening it. So, yeah, I'm excited to dig in here and see what you guys pull.
I know it hasn't been easy to get product, and you and I have talked about that. So I appreciate you going above and beyond to be able to score this box for your appearance tonight.
Yeah, no doubt. You know, I definitely has been a little tough. We've all had to adapt to, you know, this new normal that we're living in here. But, you know, I said, hey, we got to be on a GTS. So let's get some product and rip it open.
I love it. So what is it? 24 packs that we're going through, right, Rob?
Yes. 6 cards per pack.
Awesome. And, you know, we talk about the one, there's baseball player autos in here.
Oh, I was hoping we'd get one of these. This is one of the glow in the dark cards.
Oh, that's just what I was going to ask about, the non-subject, like the non-sports subjects, but so many still cool cards. I don't know if we're going to be able to get the effect, but
yeah, I don't think I'm going to be able to because of the nature of needing light for the show, but it's cool.
Yeah, you know, it's funny what it's almost like I said, there's something around every turn in Allen and Ginter. And even though we have non-baseball subjects, which oftentimes get, you know, a lot of the popularity, get talked about a lot because their autos are in there, you also have really interesting just inserts and subsets, such as that down on the farm cow that you just pulled, or, oh,
this
look at Doc Emmerich.
Awesome.
How cool is that?
I've said it on the show before. I've had the pleasure of working a couple of Stanley Cups and meeting Doc and actually having conversation with him and enjoying a meal pregame. And he is the real deal. He's one of those people that's so genuine. And, you know, I was kind of starstruck, and he was more interested in hearing my story. And it was he's just one of those type of people. Absolute best. He won an Emmy again this year for best play-by-play in sports. So
yeah, he's been busy in the NHL bubble. I know that, but look at that poll. That is awesome that he just popped up.
Oh, a little old school Fred McGriff.
Now, Emily, I know that you don't do the product development, you know, but that you are pretty well versed in it. And you mentioned a few female athletes that make their way into this product. Obviously, sports, you know, the big four are male dominated. But can you talk just a little bit about what Topps is doing? Because I love the amount of female collectors that I see on Twitter. I also love the fact that, you know, there's some people that maybe aren't collecting these sports, but love some of these other things. How is Topps sort of pushing that and making more widely demanded cards, or making cards for that audience as well?
Sure, absolutely. And, you know, it's a great question and a great thought because, you know, like you said, the big four sports, they're male dominated. And so naturally you have a lot of men in the hobby. But one thing that I thought was just so cool this year, and this was back in March, we had, I'm chasing behemoths beneath. So you might have to send that one my way.
Do a little trade for those autograph cards we got.
You know, I love the irony of that one too, because while it's behemoths beneath, they're on the mini cards. So I love the irony there. But, you know, back in March, we had a Women of Star Wars set, and it was the first time we had an all-female checklist, all-female signers. And while it's not necessarily in sports, it's just one of the ways that I think Topps is really expanding to appeal to different audiences. And Allen and Ginter is, of course, a great example of one of the ways we do that. I mean, from Andy Cohen to Spike Lee to look at him right there, Mr. Chip Gaines. You know, it's really cool how many different types of people that we reach with this product.
That's the one for your daughters, right, Rob? Yeah. You need to pull two of them, right? And you need to pull his wife.
Yep.
Yes, they're on a dual card together.
Very cool. Now, also, Emily, so you are, is it head of marketing? Is that your title, director of marketing?
Our director, communications manager.
That's applicable. Communications manager. Our director of marketing is Wendy Friedman, who is just fantastic to work under. But yeah, we've been.
She is great. I love
her. Yeah, Wendy's great. Look at that one there, Craig B.
Yeah, you got to make sure on the minis that you check the back, right? Because there's different back variants.
Yeah,
so that's important. Sort.
Allen and Ginter, I mean, it's totally hats off to the brand team and the editors of the product and even the design team, too. It's just so unique, the product. There's, like I said, something around every turn, and it's really fun to rip open, see what kind of quirky things you might end up with. But, yeah, you want to look twice at every card. You never know what even if it might look like a normal base card or what have you, you just never know.
Speaking of the reasons why, let's talk about the return of the Ginter code. What? It has been so hard in past years that it hasn't been solved until like after the release of the next year's.
Yep.
Do you have any tips, any clues, any hints?
Well, I can tell you that, oh no, I can't tell you guys anything.
It's an enigma.
I will tell you that it is so secretive that they do not even trust me with the information, because I get too excited about things like that. And I think I'll just go tweeting about it. So, I do not know anything about the Ginter code, or rather I don't have anything to share with you about the Ginter code. Cool card back there for Jock Peterson. But yeah, it is. It's a fun one. It gets people, you know, just going crazy over what they might find, what kind of clues they might put together. And I know that it's definitely been a little bit of a team effort the past couple of years of everyone just putting the pieces together of the Ginter code. So if I find any inside info, I will let you know. But like I said, I just don't think they trust me with the secrecy.
Well, I know you've been on the other side of the microphone before, so you know I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't try. Speaking of Bucky Lassick,
there you go. Yeah, so, cool to have those guys in there for sure.
So you did mention something that you might go tweeting about it. And so while I have you, I do just want to sort of ask, obviously, you know, Topps collectors love Topps, and collectors have a lot of issues with Topps. Topps tweeted out not too long ago about this show, and people immediately start asking for statements on customer service issues, you know, the shipping of bin baller chrome boxes. I see a tweet about that. And honestly, I mean, Emily, you know, I'm sure if you saw with the million dimensions, I tweeted something today and tagged Topps that was, you know, hey, not everybody's always happy. Can you at least tell us, though, you know, when it comes to communication, what is productive that we can expect from social media from a major company? And what is it that sadly we're just never going to get? Like, where's sort of that line for us? Because you're a human. You're trying, right? You don't just hate us.
Sure. No, I love you guys. That is fantastic. I can tell you that all of our customer service inquiries should go to customer service. So, you know, our social, love that, debut to remember Aaron Judge card. The one thing I love about those debut to remembers is on the back of them, they have just a really cool, you know, story about everyone's debut all the way from Judge, Willie, you know, McCovey, really cool stuff. But, social media is really a place for us to, communicate about the product, tease the product images, what might be in there, interact with fans. But, because we have I'm grateful to have so many followers. It's unfortunate that, you know, we just can't get to all the customer service inquiries. And that's why we have a dedicated team for customer service. So, while we have a lot of DMs about, hey, I didn't get my order and I'd love to help everyone I can. It's, supposed to go through CS. But, from our social pages, of course, we're going to have giveaways. You can actually expect a giveaway for a box of Allen and Ginter this upcoming weekend. So, stay tuned. Go over to the Tops pages, give us a follow, and make sure, you're tuned in to see how you can win a box. But Sakura Kokumai, who you just pulled, is actually going to represent the USA in the Olympics, which was supposed to be this summer, but so it's cool to have Olympians in the set as well.
What's been your strategy on the two platforms between Instagram and Twitter?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think Twitter is a place for conversation and Instagram is a place for, photos. It's very visual, of course. That's the intention of Instagram. So we've been able to put a lot of unique, photos on there, cards, some things that people can engage with behind the scenes, whatever that is. Whereas Twitter is a much more conversational platform where you can, post your polls, reply to this thread with your polls and people are actually able to, reply back with photos. Whereas Instagram, you could really only comment. You can't reply back with a photo. So cool 432 Park Ave building. I can probably see it if I go down to the waterfront here in Hoboken.
Now, but, are other cards on the checklist, if you put them all together, will it make some sort of skyline?
I believe that's just the tallest towers, that subset.
Got it. Okay.
Yep. So all unique, but, obviously the front of it is not your standard Allen and Ginter look, I suppose. But, it's a fun one, too.
Reach for the sky.
They have everything from reach to the sky to behemoths beneath. So it when we say Allen and Ginter spans, it truly does, from tallest buildings to deepest sea creatures.
Yeah, in fact, this year there's one of the panoramas in the Reach for the Sky is One World Trade Center. So very cool. I'm looking at that on a checklist right now.
It's cool. When I commute into the office, which hasn't been for a while, I actually commute into One World Trade Center. So it's neat to, be chasing that card that you walk into every day.
A little bit of a different mini with a special black design border there.
I also love the way that, the cards almost appear as though there's like an extra layer of depth, that shadow on the right hand side behind that mini. It's almost like the cards are coming out of the card. It's a cool depth type of perspective that the design team added. And I love that.
Yeah, there are also stained glass minis. They're not numbered, but it has been released that they have 25 copies each. So if you get a stained glass mini, even though there isn't a number on it.
Actually, Ivan,
yeah,
you would do well to read your hobby happenings.
Did that change?
Emily, as long as I've got you, would you like to explain something that was tweeted out about the stained glass minis?
Yes, I believe there was a collation error, and I'm pulling up my tweet so I can get it word for word here. But, Ivan...
Seriously, Ivan, read the darn notes next time.
It's quite all right. Listen, so unfortunately, sometimes production errors and whatnot, pop up. But I believe that all of the stained glass, the minis, were inserted into the box loader rip cards. So it's not just the stained glass mini exclusives. Like, you're not going to find those in the packs. But, Ivan, you'll have to, make sure you have Tops on notifications.
Sorry. at 3:08 p.m., I was on the phone with our producer trying to get
This was yesterday. What was your?
You sent the notes yesterday.
No, what was your excuse yesterday when they tweeted it?
That I didn't have tops on notifications. I'm going to go fix that right now, Emily. Tops on notifications.
Love to hear it.
I go through all this effort to put a nice segment together called Hobby Happenings, and I got the slides and screen grabs and was going to explain later in the show what happened.
And listen,
Ivan says, hey, look for stained glass minis. Nope.
That's what happens when I open a competitor's checklist website. That's what happens when I open a competitor's checklist website during our segment.
Instead of GoGTS.
I won't say who, but remember, GoGTS.net for all your checklist news information needs.
Here's a behemoth beneath of the orca whale for you.
I love that. See, if only the behemoths beneath insert was last year when I had my Shark Week shirt on, it would have been a perfect marriage. But maybe that's why I'm chasing it this year, to make up for lost time.
Yeah, that's a nice design element along the edge there with the shadowing. That's very cool. Gives it a pop.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, another eclectic set that I've already seen a few popping up on eBay, just ridiculous prices. Fossilized sea creatures.
How cool!
So
is
you
that?
Can actually get a bit of a fossilized sea creature in a trading card in Allen and Ginter this year.
Yeah, the brand team just thinks, you Ooh, know,
Gavin Lux, mini rookie.
Oh, there you go. Outside of the box, the brand team just does an awesome, awesome job. And there you go. Nice Gavin Lux. And even the photos they use, I know that goes through our editors. I love the photos that are used in Allen and Ginter as well.
Boom. Irrigator rookie card.
There you go. Down on the farm.
Nice.
And at first when they said there was a down on the farm subset, I'm like, oh, that's weird. Are they going to have like prospects in the set? Like I'm thinking in total baseball terms. And then I read the checklist and I'm like, oh no, there's bales of hay in here. That's something else.
You know, one of the things that I was really disappointed about this whole COVID thing was having to cancel the Field of Dreams game. I was really looking forward to some unique content coming out of that game. Hopefully they can get that back on the schedule for another date and time, because I'm sure Topps could do some cool stuff with that.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a shame. You know, this year has definitely been a bit of a shame, but it only gives us more to look forward to next year. And I know that they slotted in the Cardinals, so they'll be playing in something that looks like those corn stacks next year. But they slotted in, I believe, the Cardinals to play the White Sox, if I'm not mistaken.
And I don't know why the Cardinals, given that the fact of that storyline, shouldn't it be the White Sox and the Cincinnati Reds? You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, they originally had the Yanks in there too, which was, you know, might have just been the way the schedules worked out for travel. But love that Clevinger card there, Mike Clevinger. No, he's in the Indians jersey, but still fun card.
Can you talk a little bit about, so you mentioned obviously the celebrities in this product, that it's their first time having a baseball card. They're excited to tweet about it or do a little promo of some sort. What about, though, the rookies like Bo Bichette, Luis Robert, Gavin Lux? Is there any effort to sort of activate them on social media to start talking about cards in some ways?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think that because the nature of Allen and Ginter is so wacky, I'll say, it's really just about those unique aspects in the set, such as a Paul Rudd autograph card, right? Mm-hmm. But when it comes to the actual baseball players and you really want to hit that baseball audience, we would use those social activations for something more along the lines of, you know, a Series 1 or what have you. So most of the Allen and Ginter marketing aspect and communications aspect really revolves around that, pop culture. And sometime this week, too, we pulled a Doc Emrick card. I'm sure we'll tweet it out from the Topps account, but UpRocks, the media site UpRocks, is going to have a piece on, and they actually interviewed Doc Emmerich for it. So I'm really looking forward to
seeing that. Oh, that's great. I love UpRocks.
Yeah, yeah. UpRocks is great. And, you know, Doc was nice enough to take the time to do an interview, you know, about the card and everything. So, you know, it's really those unique aspects to the set and those pop culture, just non-baseball subjects that we really lean into for Allen and Ginter.
I'm turning on Twitter notifications for UpRocks as we speak.
Now you're on it.
Lesson learned.
Right? Now, Kelsey was writing for you guys, and he asked me a really fun question. So I think I have to turn around and pose the question back to you guys. But he asked me if there was anyone that I would want to collect in Allen and Ginter, who would it be? And I thought I would say, you know, Bruce Springsteen, because I'm here in New Jersey and, you know, big Springsteen fans. And then I went into a whole, you know, it would be great if we had a subset of just New Jersey musicians, right? So Frankie Valli in the Four Seasons, and Frank Sinatra was born in Jersey. So I want to ask you guys, if you could see anyone in Allen Ginter, who would you want to collect?
Anybody that... not in the set now, but who we'd like to see in the set, if possible.
Anyone at all.
Oh, interesting.
So it's kind of funny that you bring up Springsteen in Jersey, because
boom, I'm actually, we got a Jersey card.
Oh, hey.
A funny mini frame Jersey card of Clayton Kershaw.
Oh, nice. That is awesome. Look at that design around the frame, too. I love that.
It's beautiful.
Nice.
So we got to give that away, Ivan, for sure.
Got it.
Okay, so that's an interesting question. Did you have an answer right away, Ivan?
I didn't, except that I love the fact that another great band out of Jersey, the Gaslight Anthem, their lead singer, Brian Fallon, actually had a card last year.
He did, so yes.
I was able to add another Jersey band that's great. But Springsteen, that's a hard one to top. I don't even... Wow, because that would be perfect.
It would be fun to have a whole subset of Jersey musicians. We'd have the, you know, I think My Chemical Romance and Gaslight Anthem. They'd all be in the subset.
So actually, I can't. This is the problem being the communications manager. You get all the beef, right? All the beef and none of the fun. but I have a bit of a beef just with the fact that this year, with the popularity of Project 2020, like, why were the Project 2020 artists not part of this? You know, because you've got the Ben Baller Chrome set out now, and I've had five people tweet me in the last week saying, how do I get a Ben Baller autograph card? I'm like, wow, that would have been perfect in Allen and Ginter. So I would say, just because of the connection to baseball cards, I would love to see those artists, you know, even if next year people have moved on, I'd love to see those artists have an official card and have an official autograph. I'd enjoy collecting that entire set myself.
Yeah, no, I couldn't agree more. And you know, really, I think it just had to do with the timing. You know, a lot of this is, most of our products are planned so far in advance, and you have to get the subject list in so far in advance. And I don't actually think that, you know, Project 2020 was released or had really taken off in the way that, you know, it did right in the beginning. And, you know, kind of by that time, I think everything was really set for Allen and Ginter. But I couldn't agree more. I think they would make a great addition to next year's set, or just to have, you know, the Project 2020 artist subset would be a lot of fun.
And on the same token, Mayumi Sato, who's done a lot of the Topps living art, I think would be an incredible subject for a card too. So
her living set pieces are just, they're incredible. They're so lifelike and gorgeous. It's just, yeah, it'd be fun to have a whole, you know, even sketch card artist subset. There's so many things that happen, you know, that go into creating a product, such as sketch cards and our living set or Project 2020 and so many different people, you know, museum collection even, that participate with Topps and, you know, create unbelievable cards. It'd be fun to include them in Allen and Ginter. Please do.
Oh.
That's a bold name to throw out there.
He's all in.
I mean, you would think you'd have a little cachet with him because of Topps handling, you know, the Star Wars brand and doing so well over the years. You know, I don't think that's an outrageous ask.
No, no, definitely. It's a fair thing to say. That's a fair suggestion. It'll go on the list for next year. Mm-hmm. We'll put it in the suggestion box.
Personally, I get tired of dudes on cards. I'd like to see a subset every year with themed with different women, whether it's music divas or fashion or science, women of science. I don't care. Mm. I think it'd be nice to mix that up a little bit like that.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that's also why I'm so excited for the Olympics and any of our, you know, USA Olympics type of cards. Speaking of, he's got his American flag wrapped around his shoulders. But yeah, you know, we cover all of them. You know, who else was in Allen Ginter? Simone Manuel, Megan Rapinoe, Alex Morgan. I mean, we just had some really, you know, fun girls in there this year. But love the idea of you know, female musicians or female scientists. That's a fun idea. Would definitely make a unique set for sure.
Awesome. This I'm also is thinking really, really fun. Always an eclectic break. Man, I love the minis.
I was just gonna throw in there, Rob, I don't know that Pepperoni has had a rookie card yet.
Oh, pizza toppings. You could do a pizza toppings insert.
There you go. That I love that. Some sort of pie in the sky kind of thing.
Yeah. All right. Look at that.
I am going to reciprocate, and I am going to send you these three.
Wow. Oh, I'm so close to all 20 of them. I'm three more closer. Wow. I'm honored.
I really dig these glow in the dark where monsters live cards. That's a cool idea.
Yeah, totally cool. And it kind of, you know, like you said in the beginning, Rob, how, you know, Chip Gaines said his inner 10-year-old is excited. I think, you know, opening up baseball cards is you have this childlike happiness or euphoria when you do so. And that particular, you know, where monsters live subset, it kind of brings you back to that childhood. Are they under my bed? Are they in my closet? Are they in the attic? So it's a fun subset to be included in Allen and Ginter, just because it's such a childlike fear. And, you know, opening up cards, I think, just gets everyone giddy. So, yeah, it's a really fun one to have in there. Never mind the really cool design.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, listen, Emily, anything else that you want to leave some parting wisdom with the viewers before we let you go?
Oh, this was great, guys. Thanks so much. You know, like I said, we're going to have a giveaway from our Topps Twitter page this upcoming weekend for a box of Allen and Ginter. So definitely everyone head over to our page. You know, Saturday morning, the giveaway will go live. So, you know, enter for your chance to win. But no, this is great, guys. Really, really appreciate it. It was fun, you know, hanging out and cracking open some Ginter. This is it's just such a fun product, really unique one. And I love, you know, I'll be on the lookout for my Behemoths Beneath cards, definitely.
Can I share with the audience the last email nugget that you sent me?
Please do.
Well, check this out, guys. So she really, really wanted us to be able to have a box to look at while we were talking. And all she could get her hands on in time was this retail box, which was awesome. And I know some of you out there are going, well, what about a hobby box? Well, she got one. She's hooked. She's going to hook us up. You're just going to have to wait. Okay. So she's got one for us. And thank you so much. I mean, this is above and beyond. It's awesome.
Yep. You know, I was unfortunately don't receive as much product just because there's been a lot of, you know, shipping difficulties and production difficulties with the year that 2020 has been. And Rob, when you had reached out to me about being on the show, I'm like, absolutely, first and foremost, because I haven't you know, been on in a while, and I love joining the show. But Allen Ginter is great, and then I said to myself, "Oh no, how am I going to get product?" So I was, you know, Kevin O'Neill was nice enough to get some some boxes my way. And, you know, so I sent the first one that I got to you just to make sure it would be there by today. But now that I have a hobby box, I'm going to make sure that we send this to you as well. And then you guys can open again on the show or whatever you'd like to do with it. Love it.
I'm not speaking out of turn when I say you do get dibs on all the behemoths beneath from that box also. That's fair, yeah, right?
For sure.
Amazing. I will, I'll put it, you know, with my whole collection and my own Allen and Ginter card, which I keep in my wallet.
That's awesome. So, all right, Ivan, we're going to have three winners out of this box. One winner, obviously, is going to get the jersey card. Mm-hmm. One winner is going to get the two glow-in-the-dark cards, although I am so tempted to keep those for myself. I might just have to go buy, like, five boxes and start collecting. And then another will get the entire stack of minis minus the behemoth cards.
That's fair. Absolutely okay. Fair. So they'll get the, including the Gavin Lux, Allen and Ginter back. And the, I saw there was another Allen and Ginter back. So, all three of those lots are going to be good lots to win. Nice. Real quick, go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive, to enter to win. You'll see the tweet just went out with that. And not only follow Tops on Twitter, turn on your notifications. Lessons learned.
We'll keep you in the know that way. And listen, I knew, you know, I was going to be in the hot seat here, but that one really threw me for a loop, Ivan. So touche there.
Hot seat for you. Very embarrassing cold seat in the mountains for me.
Oh, Emily, it's always fun. And so glad to see people without a mask on in a communal setting, such as virtual as it is, it's nice to be able to get together like this. And I can't wait till we're all back in person again. But listen, we're going to have to do this again because I always forget how much fun I have when you're on the show.
Yeah, I want to come back on to open the hobby box. So when we get that sent out, I'm going to have to.
Deal. Yeah. Done deal.
All right, done perfect. I'm weaseling my way back on just, you know, just for the behemoths beneath. but no, thank you guys. It's always so much fun. And yes, absolutely nice to have some FaceTime without a mask and open some Allen and Ginter while we do so.
Awesome. Awesome. Have a great weekend, and we will talk to you sooner than we thought.
You guys too. Thanks so much.
Bye, Emily. Emily Kless, Marketing Communication Manager at Topps. She does a great job over on Topps. Her own account, just look for Emily Kless. She's a good follow and mm-hmm. a great lady. We're happy to call her a friend of the program. Yeah. Wow, Ivan, that was awesome.
Double shout out again for the very first box she got, sending it over to us just so we could at least see the product. I know that a retail box doesn't have exactly as many hits as a hobby box.
We did right?
Well, first off, we did good. You know, we kind of glossed over the Gavin Lux was an Allen and Ginter back mini. So that's an insert, you know, parallel. Great card. But I loved it was right in the middle of another question. So she glossed over a little bit. But like the debut moments or memories, you know, like she said, these are baseball cards. They have stories on the back. Like, just sit back and enjoy these cards a little bit. Enjoy the checklist, you know, like I'm glad to see this with all the crazy hype that's been going on in the hobby. This is a good product for us to just enjoy, you know.
This was a different order, Gavin Lux. You can threw me off. It doesn't have an A and G back.
Oh, I saw the front was different border. Okay.
Yes. There you go. Yeah.
Again, okay. There's so much going on with this product.
Right.
You know, there's Allen and Ginter back minis, black bordered minis, no number minis, numbered to 50, Brooklyn back minis, numbered to 25. I'm just going to shut up now. Stained glass minis are available. They're just in a different spot. I can't believe I'm not going to call out which checklist site I was on either, but
We're going to dive into that in our next segment here. As soon as I just do a little bit of housekeeping here. I mean, you made me spit my water on that one.
It's your story. I looked at it and I'm like, oh, it's your story. I don't read your stories.
So
I know. We had a lot.
All right. Just a handful of stuff going on, news, notes, and nuggets wise in a segment we like to call Hobby Happenings. But let's talk about it. So to kick things off, here's a pretty great story from Sports Collectors Daily that I saw this week. Sometimes those unclaimed property announcements from your state government can actually be worth looking into, as a St. Louis area man found that to be the case last week. He'd actually thought he'd lost part of his sports card collection for good, but instead received a nice surprise this week. Kevin Kelly accumulated a rather sizable collection, but stashed some of it away about 20 years ago in a safe deposit box. Eventually, as often happens, he forgot about it and lost touch with the bank where they'd been stored. Well, as part of Missouri's recent push to return unclaimed property, Kelly got his cards back this week. In fact, Missouri State Treasurer Scott Fitzpatrick returned what ended up being thousands of dollars worth of baseball and other sports cards to Kelly in person on Wednesday. There were hundreds of cards in all, including a 1980-81 Topps Larry Bird Magic Johnson rookie card, sweet, a 53 Bowman Mickey Mantle. Hey, I own 1.000 something of that. A 1960 Topps Mantle, a 1962 Topps Lou Brock rookie card, an autographed Musial card, as well as rookie cards of players like Joe Montana, Ozzie Smith, and Tiger Woods, which have all gone up in value considerably since Kelly had stashed them away at the end of the last millennium. I love a story with a happy ending, so very cool.
In hobby startup business news, Josh Luber has left StockX. In case you didn't know, Luber is a well-known sneaker collector who co-founded StockX, the stock market for things where collectors can go on and buy and sell products just like they would on eBay, but through a bid and ask system. Josh originally worked for IBM and then left there when he founded Campless, a sneakerhead data company that tracked the secondary market for sneaker sales. Luber then used that knowledge as an inspiration for starting StockX, originally with a focus on sneakers. Luber had stepped down as CEO last year and told The Business of Fashion that it was always my intention from the day I started StockX that I would start another startup and then probably another after that, another one and another one. We do wish Josh luck in his new endeavors and thank you for the impact that you've brought to the hobby with StockX so far.
Absolutely. And with an even quicker note, PSA announced that in their ongoing efforts to improve efficiency and turnaround times, that they've introduced a new PSA submission ID labeling system. Collectors can, I assume, download and affix the label to the side of their packaging. And that way, when it arrives at PSA, the barcode will be scanned and the submitter will receive an email alert that their submission has arrived. Pretty cool. But unfortunately, on a bit of a sad note, the IX Center in Cleveland, the scheduled site of the 2022 National Sports Collectors Conventions and many others before that, has announced that it will be closing its doors as a result of the economic impact of the COVID pandemic. Some of my best memories of the National are actually in Cleveland. And Ivan, wasn't that the site of your first National?
Side of my first National, side of my first, time getting to know you, getting to know so many other great collectors, side of a few more Nationals after that, and that famous Ferris wheel in the middle that goes about 200 miles per hour. It will be missed. It will be missed.
There's no word yet from promoters as to a new venue in Cleveland or if a location change will need to be made. Sad, really sad.
We do have a potential game-changing business entry into the sports card market to announce tonight. TCG Player a highly respected media and technology leader in the trading card game category, has announced a massive expansion as a result of its intention to enter other collectible categories, including sports cards. The company holds a proprietary point-of-sale system for selling single cards that has been trumpeted by retailers as key to increasing sales revenue and, in some cases, outright saving their businesses. I have no clue what that means. However, we will keep track of this developing story and update you as more information becomes available, and we'll fill you in on that more and more. Also, if you live near Syracuse, New York, Atlanta, Georgia, or fit the qualifications for one of their remote positions.
Wait. Can you back up? If you live near Syracuse, New York, Atlanta, Georgia. I put some commas in there. I shouldn't have.
I'm like, hey, Georgia is a very respected country. You know, they do hire some remote positions, you know. So Syracuse or Atlanta, or there are remote positions available. It's worth noting that TCG Player is hiring over 50 people across all departments as a result of this endeavor. So search for them online to find out about that. Rob, can I throw a quick addendum on here for Hobby Happenings?
Sure.
Our guest last week, Collectible App, we talked about the 1953 Topps Mickey Mantle last week that they released fractional share investing on, today announced their second or did their second fractional share investing. Yes. This time a 2003 LeBron James signed SP Authentic autographed rookie card. Now, it was only a small fraction of the value that was made open to investors, about $50,000. However, that $50,000 in $25 a piece shares sold out within the day to 178 different investors. So just a quick follow up on last week's sort of feature.
Very cool. Well, hey, Ivan, like I said, it's back. So guys out there, keep all your cards, all your wrappers, all your boxes for now anyway, and follow the Ginter code on Twitter. Also, Topps announced a couple of production errors on social media. First, all stained glass minis, as we discussed, were mistakenly inserted into the box loader rip cards, not just the stained glass mini exclusive. So unfortunately, no stained glass minis will be found in packs of Allen and Ginter, which is a bummer because I think they are one of the coolest inserts in the product. And second, due to an additional printing error, none of the Safari site's box loaders were made, period. However, collectors will still find the mini insert set in packs. But from every picture I've seen to date, they've been horribly miscut. So Topps printer has some splaining to do, if you ask me. And that's a look at this week's Hobby Happenings. It's been all Topps up until now, and we are happy to get them back in the fold. Obviously, you guys have noticed we've had, you know, a bit of a lack of Topps product over COVID, and hopefully we'll get that rectified and back on track over the coming months. But like I said, Emily and Kevin and everybody went out of their way to make sure we had something to show you guys related to Allen and Ginter, and the fact that we're going to get a hobby box on top of it is just even a bonus. So thank you to all involved there.
You know, it is kind of interesting, Rob. I was thinking about this when Emily reminded me that, you know, she's working remote, the office is in New York City. You know, as much of a, believe me, I know we all have different experiences and opinions. Being in the mountains has given me one, but it is interesting just to think that, you know, Topps' headquarters versus the other company's headquarters is in a highly congested, highly population density area. And so they've probably had some unique challenges that, you know, some of the other manufacturers maybe haven't had at the same scale. just with, you know, promotional product going into the office and things of that nature. So
exactly. It's not like they up and decided one day, yeah, we're not going to send those jerks over at GoGTS Live.
Well, or anybody, you know, like the, just a lot of interesting challenges which people are figuring
out. All right. Well, here's a product that we've enjoyed year in and year out. And thanks to Upper Deck and Chris Carlin and team over at Upper Deck for hooking us up with some Marvel Masterpieces. This is a 12-pack per box product with three cards per pack. Ivan, are you able to tell us? I know we've got art from the one and only Dave Palumbo, but what should we be looking for? Anything specific, like guaranteed?
Yeah, so there's quite a few different pieces per box. If I'm reading this right, because it does use the word and, so every once in a while that gets overly complicated with these types of products, but one original sketch card, one canvas gallery, one battle spectra, I'm sure we'll figure out what that means when we see it, one hollow foil design, and one preliminary art variant card in every box. And that's not to mention that there are some so there's this website, gogts.net. Obviously that's the website that, you know, GTS and the show, gogts.net, GoGTS Live. You want to look at the checklist while you open this product, because there's four different tiers of rarity across base cards. There's case hits, including Dave Palumbo autograph parallel cards. They're not exactly case hits. They're 1-2-2 per case. So probably like 3-2 cases, I'm guessing, but we're not given specifics on that here. We might deeper in the checklist. One Mirage lenticular card per case, and some other monster hits, including uncut sheet redemptions. Can you imagine an uncut sheet of these incredible art cards? Redemptions for original paintings from Dave Palumbo. Redemptions for comic book sketch covers by Dave Palumbo. So basically, aside from just making an incredible Marvel set here, Upper Deck has made sort of a Dave Palumbo feature where, you know, I imagine they had to do some work with him to say, hey, what do you have that we can put in this product?
Can I interrupt you?
Yeah, please.
Does it say that the base cards are numbered, or did I get a parallel and don't know how to identify it of Ex Nihilo?
Yeah, I definitely cannot imagine that the base cards are numbered. Is that just your first card?
99. Yeah, it's my first card.
Oh, well, what do you know? Actually, yeah, base cards. So this is what, gogts.net. Open the checklist. Base cards are numbered to 1,999.
Nice.
So tier one is numbered. Tier two is numbered 1,499. Tier three is numbered 999. Tier four, level four, is numbered to 99. Yeah. So if you get cards 82 through 90, those are numbered to just 99. And then you got to look at all the parallel numbers, and they've all got different, you know, I wish I could do a screen
share.
Here's
card number one, Dr. Octopus, also numbered 1,499. So that's cool.
Yeah. So the odds configuration on this is so tough. Again, you want to go to gogts.net while you open your box and just like look at every single thing when it comes to what the odds are. Because even among the insert sets, there's different odd tiers. Let me just scroll down.
1,999.
Yeah, you hear some
This one's numbered to just 499.
Egghead.
I thought that was you pumping in, James, some sort of sound effect like you're bored. I was like, geez.
Yeah, thank God it didn't start until after Emily got off, right? It's like, get with the program. No. Yeah, sorry, I'm just clicking down on a checklist right now. That's the exciting thing that I'm doing. But yeah, this is so eclectic and so beautiful. I tell you, like, I've got a few goals for retirement. One goal for retirement is to watch every single Simpsons episode.
That's a good
The one. Other one is to like open a box of this from various years every month. Open a new box or build a set of this every year when I can actually stop and pause and enjoy life. So, wow.
Jean Grey.
What card number is that Venom?
This is called Preliminary Art, and it is card number 18.
Oh, so is that our variant? Our Preliminary Art variant. Cool. So I'm going to need a screenshot of that in a minute, but right now I'm still playing around with this checklist. Preliminary. Where's the preliminary?
Did you see this one? The Namor. This is a special limited edition holo foil, card number 4 of 20. This is really colorful. If you missed it, show it off for you.
Okay, so that's one of our inserts. 1 in 12 packs. It's not a speckle parallel, is it? Number to 99? Or a kaleidoscope parallel, number to 25. That sounds pretty cool, too. Preliminary art variant, number 18, Venom.
Ghost Spider base card, number to 1499. Here's a purple version base, number to 199. Vela.
Gosh, this is a day that I'm actually bummed I'm not in the chat to see the comments and stuff, especially from people that are comic fans.
Captain Britain.
I've been getting a lot of tweets lately from people that are collecting comics saying, you know, the comic world is going through a lot of the same buzz that the card world is going through. I mentioned that Venom because, you know, they do these variants where Venom pops up in, you know, Hulk, and Venom pops up in Deadpool, and they do one-offs, and those seem to be incredibly popular from my very surface level understanding of comics and collectibility. Is that Star-Lord?
This is Blade.
Oh, no, it's Blade.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm on a laptop. It's real small there.
All right, we have a much different insert here. Battle Spectra. Okay. Old Man Logan versus Scarlet Samurai.
Let me get a screenshot of that. Nice. You know, Rob, I'm just realizing we dropped the ball.
Uh-oh.
We should have figured out how to get this Dave Palumbo on the show.
We could have, probably. You're right.
Yeah, yeah. It would have been tough for tonight, but man, well, you don't happen to... This isn't one of those you're going to pull a surprise second box out of the closet, are you?
No, not tonight.
Okay. Well, yeah, but next week when we have Dave Palumbo on, right? Because it would be so cool to be able to go over this with the artist. You know, right, hear his inspiration.
This is a... Ooh. Timely card. Oh, very sad. Canvas Gallery Black Panther. Beautiful canvas texture.
Wow.
Wakanda Forever. Black Widow.
Is that a gold signature on there?
Yeah. We pulled a few of those.
Okay. So that must be like the... hold on, I'm scrolling back up through the 33-page checklist. Silver Spectrum Foil Parallel, Artist Auto Parallel. Yeah.
Grim Reaper.
Or Red Spectrum, which are 101s. There's got to be a different spectrum that's less...
Oh, here's one of those limited edition holo foils that is numbered to 99. What'd you say, speckled? Of Colossus, yeah. No less. That's cool.
Oh, man. I've somehow got a screenshot that sort of captures that shine, too.
Beautiful.
That's really cool.
Gore, the God Butcher.
Is that numbered on the back?
It is not.
Okay. So I'm trying to figure this out from the checklist. So the gold foil parallels, it says, are not numbered. But then when it says silver artist, it says just 10. But there's no way we pulled three silver spectrum foil artist parallels in there.
No.
Numbered to 10. What?
Pip the troll.
I need a product manager on the show with me when we do this.
Another canvas gallery and another great character in Thanos.
My wife and I disagree on Thanos. I love him, at least in the movies. I recognize that Thanos in the movies is a lot different than Thanos in the comics in some ways.
I love him in the movies too, and I think Josh Brolin is absolutely great as him.
My wife just hates him, and I'm like, how can you not like understand the push-pull of the character?
Totally.
Yeah. Ooh, that's a cool...
A second preliminary art variant. This one of Baron Zemo. Nighthawk.
Gosh, Rob. I don't know what to do because when I do a tweet for this product, Twitter only lets me put four pictures in one tweet.
Well, and there's not a this one from artist Jude Gallagher, one of one. Sketch card.
Oh, there we go.
I feel foolish for having to ask this, but who is that? What character is that?
You don't know?
That could
be... I want to say the Mandalorian, but that's not right. doesn't say anywhere on the back there. James, are you able to see the chat? Because I can't see the chat. I'm sure somebody in the chat can tell us. Who is the... Oh, wow. Okay, so the checklist, again, just has the artists. Who is the artist on this again?
Jude Gallagher.
Yeah, it just has the artist, but it doesn't actually have, of course, the all the one-of-one sketch cards. So...
Oh, the brain planet from Guardians of the Galaxy. I think you're right there. I like that guess. I like that guess. Edge of Spider-Verse, Gwen Stacy. There. Look at this card of Deadpool. Roasting marshmallows. This is great. And our last pack. Heimdall.
Yeah, I could literally do tweets for every single card in this.
Oh, I know. It's tough. This is a base number to just $9.99 of Electra. And our last card, Bullseye.
Oh, there's our first moth.
All right. So we're obviously going to give the sketch card away. One lucky winner will get the two preliminary art variants. So that's prize winner number two. One winner will get the two canvas gallery cards. I have one here. I put the other in the wrong stack. Apparently, there it is. And then one other person will get all three, the Spectre Battle, and let's just call it the Shiny Card Lot. So four winners from this box.
All right. I love it. It's going to take me just a minute to get a tweet out for that because I was stuck watching it, didn't know we were going to pull next.
I'm going to update the poll question while you take care.
We'll get that out. Remember twitter.com/goGTSLive. It'll be up in just a minute. You got to retweet. You have to be following us and you have to be watching live at the end when we announce the winners to qualify. So check in on Twitter or on the Go GTS Live app, which you can download if you have an Android phone, and make sure that you're doing that while staying tuned to the show.
Yeah, what he said. Let me just do a little bit of quick housekeeping here. Oh, while I shift to updating the poll question. Go GTS Live, Q of the Week poll. Who wins this year's NBA championship? Up to 250 votes now, with still about a little over 45 minutes remaining. But Lakers still in the lead at 48%. Things balanced out dead even right now between the Heat and Boston in second place. Ego, the living planet, aka Star-Lord's dad. There you go. All right. Thanks, Mike Estrich. Okay. That's that.
We're sure of that, though?
I think so. I think it makes sense.
I don't know. I feel like it's something mystic from Doctor Strange.
Like James said.
Yeah. Or like the Watcher or something. Like a take on the Watcher. I don't know. Maybe though the pores, like the planet type pores, maybe Mike's right. I don't know. I'm just going to go back to doing what I do best and sending out this tweet.
Okay. I'll start a segment in the shop. We'll look ahead at next week's new releases that'll be in hobby shops, online retailers, or with your favorite. Kick it off with 2020 Topps WWE Undisputed Wrestling cards, which is going to deliver a total of 8 autographs and 2 relic cards in every box. We have been fortunate enough to receive this product, and unfortunately it may not happen this year, guys, but if it does, you'll see it right here. You're going to get the top WWE men's and women's division superstars, WWE legends, NXT prospects on spectacular designs and premium 48-point card stock. Several different parallel levels, but none higher than 99. Also look for dual autographs numbered to 25, parallels of 10, 5, and 1 of 1. And triple autographs in the same configuration, but no 10, just 5 and 1, so much more rare. Undisputed quad autograph booklet cards, 2-panel multi-autograph cards featuring 4-person teams of WWE, numbered to just 5. Undisputed match autograph book cards, 2-panel dual autograph book cards featuring major rivals of WWE. Tribute cut signatures from guys like Ultimate Warrior. Yeah, vintage cut autographs of WWE legends, all 1-of-1s. Of course, you've got superstar roster cards highlighting the men and women's division of WWE and NXT, plus legends and rookies. New this year, or continuing this year, look for Rob Schamager illustrations, a collector favorite from last year, featuring top 10 of the men and women's division superstars. Also look for artist signed and superstar signed autograph variations of these, each limited to just 10. Next up, 2020. Oh,
sorry, I didn't.
Ready?
Yeah, it just you just said limited to 10, and that was the end. Sorry, my bad. Yeah, next up, we've got minor league baseball cards. Even though we don't have any minor leagues, we've got prospects for you. They're still out there. Pay attention to them. So this is 2020 Topps Heritage Minor League Baseball cards. Each box is going to deliver 1 autographed card, 1 relic card, and 1 1971 Greatest Moments box loader. in every box. So this highlights the young talent of Major League Baseball on the classic 1971 Topps design, including real one autograph cards of an incredible checklist, such as Adley Rutschman, last year's number one pick in the draft, or the hot prospect Bobby Witt Jr. on a 1971 Bazooka design. There's also eclectic inserts like scratch-off cards. You can find futures of the pastime autograph relic cards, 1971 Bazooka numbered test cards, coin relics. Check that out, with coins from 1971 paying homage to that particular year that the design comes from. And remember, 1971 is a tough set to grade traditionally. So, hey, you never know what the future could hold for these minor league cards if you can pull some pristine cards from that. Check out a 200-card base set to build with some top prospects as well, and base card image variations. So pay attention when you open your cards from this box. Coming to hobby shops this week, hot in the shop.
I am not ready. I am sending a chat message because, yes, we have confirmation, and we're going to show you that that is, in fact, that sketch card is Ego.
Awesome. Something right. else, actually, something that missed the pictures on that, though, there's a scratch off. You can have a chance to get a professional trading card from that last product in 2021 Topps Pro debut. From 2020 Topps Heritage Minor Leagues. Sorry, the video already moved on.
Yeah, Ivan, let me talk about Panini Chronicles baseball cards. Three autograph cards plus one memorabilia card plus two Spectra base parallels in every box. 2020 Chronicles baseball gives collectors a look at what our cards would look like across multiple brands, Panini says, including the following ones that are new this year: Mosaic, Luminance, Playbook, Magnitude, and Origins. Ooh, I love that. How about a little Origins baseball? On-card autographs, loaded rookie class in America's Pastime, Boys of Summer, Origins rookie jumbo material autographs, and more. Find the wildly popular Obsidian Optichrome base and autograph cards with multiple parallels numbered to 99 or less, as well as Spectra rookie jersey autographs, also with on-card autos from 15 of today's top prospects, and paired them with an oversized memorabilia swatch. There's a good look at what Origins baseball world would like. Brand new this year, Magnitude. Find today's biggest rookies and stars in this beautifully designed 25-card set. One of the top chase cards in Chronicles is the certified mirror gold parallels printed on PVC to give it the same shine as 1996. Look for more than 20 base cards featuring Topps rookies and superstars. Several brands represented, including Spectra, Crusade, Contenders, Optics, Certified, Limited, Titan Score, Donruss, and more. And one of the most classic designs, Contenders Optic, features a 30-card checklist loaded with today's biggest stars. In stores next week.
Rob, I really like this next product, mainly because the marketing around it is so smart. 2020 Leaf Pete Rose Charlie Hustle Edition. It's a blaster box, a fun entry-level product, which Leaf advertises is perfect for gift giving. And yeah, we're all about growing the hobby. You know, whose dad or grandpa out there wouldn't be shocked to get a Pete Rose autographed baseball card as a gift? Well, each box of this is going to deliver not only the 10-card complete Charlie Hustle set, it's also going to deliver an autographed Pete Rose baseball card. So, great way for collectors and fans who remember the incredible legacy of Pete Rose to celebrate it with some great designs. Check those out. And, you know, like I said, I love the fact that Leaf points out it's a perfect gift for that baseball card collector who remembers Charlie Hustle's legacy. Really cool product, bringing his autograph to you in a nice, easy manner. One autograph per blaster box. Can't go wrong. Thanks, Leaf.
Nice. 2019 Panini Contenders Optic NBA Basketball Cards is next up on the docket. Ooh. Delivering one autograph card plus four parallels or inserts in every box. Contenders Optic returns with a stellar lineup of autographs, inserts, and parallels. It's a quick rip, one pack, six cards, with an auto and four parallels or inserts. Pull rookie season ticket autographs in a variety of vibrant parallels, including the elusive gold vinyl, limited to just one. An incredible lineup of inserts and parallels, including brand new to the program this year, Uniformity, Historic Picks, Historic Slams, and All-Star Aspirations. 1992 tribute autographs and veteran tickets feature some of the best names across the league, old and new, with on-card autographs. Look for parallels numbered to as low as one, and find popular superstar die cut inserts and parallels numbered to 10, and the gold vinyl numbered to just one. Couple weeks late, but it's here next week.
Coming this week, we've also got a great soccer product, actually in two configurations. So we're going to talk about 2019-20 Select UEFA Euro Soccer cards, which is going to have an autograph card, a memorabilia card, and 11 base set parallels per box. There is also the Soccer Cards Hobby Hybrid configuration, which will feature one camo prism parallel, as well as four additional parallels in every box. So keep an eye out for the Hobby Hybrid edition as well. However, what you need to know is that soccer's hot, UEFA's hot, and Euro soccer is hot. And this is the first select product to hit since soccer is heated up. So you'll be able to search for great autographs, as well as inserts such as X Factor, Top of the Class, Equalizers, and Access Denied. Can only imagine that's a goalie set or defender set. Search for incredible patches such as team crests, squads, and visionary insert cards, which are short printed. So Panini is bringing that short printed paper parallel that we're looking for, ink and paper, as we call it, to the soccer world. That'll be very exciting to see. And those are only available in hobby boxes. Look for authentic autographs of European stars of the past and present, including Robert Lewandowski, Cristiano Ronaldo, Harry Kane, Sergio Ramos, Luka Modric, and many, many more. And of course, authentic memorabilia pieces and tons of parallels to chase. Got to love all those different parallel tiers. Again, this is the kind of product you're going to want the checklist open while you do it. So remember, go GTS.net. Really excited to see this in hand and see what it looks like with the soccer market where it's at. All 24 national soccer teams that qualify for the tournament will be represented in the base set. Very cool. Check it out this week.
Yeah, and like Ivan mentioned, you're going to have a couple different versions to choose from. The Hobby Hybrid set of this has some exclusives. First, it's going to deliver a camo prism parallel, four additional prism parallels, and one unlimited potential insert or parallel. Same player checklist to a large degree, but let's talk about some of the exclusives to the Hobby Hybrid SKU. Look for unlimited potential cards highlighting the best young players in Europe. These are exclusive to Hobby Hybrid packs. Look for authentic autographs in this SKU as well of European stars of the past and present in Select Signatures Green Prism and Historical Significance Green Prism, as well as special dual auto cards in past and present Green Prism and Tandems Green Prism. So all of these autographs just mentioned are only available in the Hobby Hybrid packs. The short printed inserts, Team Crest, Squad, and Visionary will be hard to find, but well worth the chase. Visit GoGTS.net to look at both products, each of which would have a complete parallel index attached, as this is going to be key to driving some of these cards' value. Hobby Hybrid and the Hobby Edition in stores next week.
Rob, this next product looks absolutely redonkulous. 2020 Super Break Heavy Hitters Basketball Edition. Now, they're advertising this as group break spots will be less than $100 a spot. There's 10 boxes with one to two cards per pack in a case. all 30 teams are represented. And looking at just the giant sell sheet for this, or the giant picture sheet, there are small cards on here, like small picture. You know, it's always the big cards that you look at. There's small cards on here that are $1,000 cards. Absolutely insane. I see one of the small pictures is a PMG Michael Jordan Fleer Metal Universe BGS 9.5. One of the small picture cards is a Zion Williamson PSA 10. You know, you see Kawhi Leonard rookie autograph parallels, low numbered parallels, LeBron James rookies, LeBron James flawless cards, Kobe Bryant autographs, Kobe Bryant. Is that, gosh, it's so small, but Kevin Durant Upper Deck rookie patch autos. Oh, big cards, Michael Jordan rookies. BGS 8.5 Michael Jordan Fleer rookies. BGS 8 is, remember I said plural, BGS 8 Michael Jordan rookie there. Absolutely insane looking configuration on this. We'll be so excited to see which breakers have this, which hobby shops have this, and who opens it. Oh, and get this, zero redemptions. It's all cards, no need for redemptions. 2020 Super Break Heavy Hitters Basketball Edition this week in hobby shops and with breakers.
Yeah, very cool. And last, but certainly not least, how about a football jersey product, an autographed football jersey product from TriStar? Game Day Greats Autographed Football Jersey Series 3. 5 autographed jerseys per case, 1 per box. Over 425 unique jerseys. All autographs have been authenticated by either TriStar themselves, PSA DNA, BAS, or JSA. Case hits, you're going to guarantee to get 2 Hall of Famers, 1 current star, and 2 fan favorites. Lots of killer players. I mean, even your fan favorites like Howard Cassidy and Johnny Leitner. I'd love to have a Leitner jersey. Current stars include Burrow, Brady, Mahomes, Lamar Jackson, Christian McCaffrey, tons of stuff, zero redemptions, limited production runs, and in stores next week. And that's a look at what's going to be hot in the shop. All right. Very cool.
So in the spirit of Ivan, being Ivan, I think I need to apologize to Mike Estrich. He knows it was never personal, but yeah. Ego is confirmed as the sketch subject from our Marvel Masterpieces box.
Thank you, Mr. Estrich.
Yeah.
All right. So GTS customer Rochester Sports Cards and Memorabilia was featured in the media spotlight this past week. And Brad Galley, who's a local reporter up there who we've featured on this program before, stopped in and had the opportunity to sit down and talk a little ripping and rip themselves. Check this out. We'll be back to announce the winners from tonight's breaks.
I'm Graham here at the Detroit News, here with Brad Galley from Channel 7. We're at the Rochester Sports Cards and Memorabilia. We're about to rip some packs, and I'm just wondering, what do you got there, and what's your ritual for opening?
So, ever since I was a little kid opening packs, my mom always said that I shake. And so, I took a break for a while in collecting, and then kind of got back into it. It's fun now that I have kids and I'm doing it. But I still get that feel and that sensation, because you never know. There could be a $10,000 card in there. There could be something monstrous. Or we could walk out of here and say, well, it was fun hanging out.
Or it's just fun opening. Yeah. I think I get that same feeling, and it's when I open up a pack, it's like, It's a callback to that when I was 7 years old, and just not knowing what you're going to, it's like a prize every time, you know. It could be a lotto ticket. It could be, it could be a crap out, but it's always fun. We got a pack of Top Chromes, or Topps Chrome. This is 2020 Topps Chrome. In this pack, this is a $12 pack. There's 4 cards. So it's not a cheap investment, but it's a gamble, but the cards are very shiny.
Yeah.
And you have the opportunity to get a nice autograph in here.
It was always a treat when Chrome came out. Like, that was a step up. If we went to the store and got a few packs of Chrome.
Yeah.
And it still is. Like, Chrome Day is a big day.
Yeah.
And plus, for any, like, new collector coming into it, they're pretty nice. But this is some of the... And how... Is this fitting or what? The first card, Miguel Cabrera.
Oh, there you go.
I mean, that works, man.
Score.
Ooh, I got a Matthew Boyd. Come on, man. Steve, thanks for hooking it up there. That's great.
Look at this.
Special packs.
You pay for the tiger packs. We did.
That's nice.
When I was a kid, man, getting a tiger was like everything.
I know. I kept all my tigers cards because I'm like, my kids will want them someday, even though they definitely probably won't. So here'll be the 101 refractor autograph that'll put my kids through college. All right, we did get a refractor rookie. Gavin Lux. Not numbered, but that's pretty slick.
I got a pack of 88 Topps baseball here.
Oh, for real?
Gonna go back in time. That's and there funny. Is indeed, because this is the question you always get asked, there is indeed a piece of gum in here.
Oh my gosh.
And it's stuck to the back of the top card. Of Bill Allman with a piece of gum on the back. There you go.
Not going to see any autographs in there.
Just cardboard stock,
right.
Kind of faded backs. And, you know, 88 Topps wasn't a great year for design.
Some of them are better than others.
But there's I got a Jack Morris, baby.
Hold that one up for the people.
For the people.
That's fantastic. That's great.
Eddie Whitson. Oh, Mike Henneman. Don't see that every day. Whoosh.
All right, first box. Can I trade you that one?
That's your guy.
Yeah, how much cool is that, man? That's fitting.
That's awesome.
He made the varsity team. I did not.
DJ LeMahieu.
It was funny, man. So we went to Brother Rice together, and our pal Mike Sullivan, who used to work at 97.1, would hit the siren at this point. But we're really good buddies, right? And there was a point where we would work out together, like in the off season for baseball, and it was kind of like, I think I should let you go hip on your own. I'm just getting in the way at this point because there's definitely a different level here. But
do you have that card yet?
I don't.
Now you do.
Is that cool?
Absolutely.
Thanks, man.
All right. Very cool look at some people enjoying the hobby up in Michigan. Okay, we've got winners.
Yes, we do. Only 7 this week, so Rob, you get a slight break from the normal crazy week, but some very cool cards. Man, I'm actually jealous of all the winners tonight. There's not a stack of this that I wouldn't like for myself. But let's start off with Topps, Allen and Ginter. So if you hear your Twitter handle called, you have to claim your prize, make it easy on us, by emailing us. gogtslive@gogts.net. Name of the show at the name of the website. Email us with your name, your Twitter handle, what you won, and your mailing address. Just 4 simple facts. Think, hey, if I wanted to get something to somebody and I wanted to check it against my list, how would I do that? Well, name, Twitter handle, address, what you won. Keep it simple. The first person that needs to do that, I know, is a pro at doing this. He's won. He's been watching the show for 5 or 6 years. I think we first met him in Cleveland at a national. So a little sad memory there. But so the Kershaw relic from Topps, Allen and Ginter, is going to EJ Bailey 54. Congratulations, EJ Bailey 54. Next up, those 2 glow in the darks. Once you get them, you got to tweet at us with a picture of them glowing in the dark. KW Bach. KW Bach. Congratulations. And then the stack of the other minis, including the rookie cards in there, is going to Carter W. Carter 69. Congratulations, Carter W. Carter. Thank you all 3 for watching the show tonight. Thank you, Emily Kless and Topps team, for letting us preview that product. Now switching to the Marvel Masterpieces. 4 really cool prizes here. First up, the preliminary art variants is going to Stockton Ellis. Congratulations, Stockton Ellis. You get the preliminary art variants from that box. The 2 canvas gallery cards is going to Heatwave 316. Congratulations, Heatwave 316. The Battle Spectra and Shiny Cards lot is going to GG Boy 65. GG spelled with J's, not G's. GG Boy 65. And then finally, that sketch card, 1 of 1, Jude Gallagher of Ego, the Living Planet, which Mike Estrich very kindly sent us a screenshot of how actually it's pretty depicted well. I'm clearly not a big enough comic nerd that I did not recognize that. from the outset. That sketch card one of one is going to Burly Man 3. Congratulations, Burly Man 3. So those are our winners tonight.
That's right.
We will have more winners again very soon, next Thursday. But wow, what a show. For a short show, a lot packed in there, right?
Absolutely. It actually went a little bit longer than I thought it would. So glad to pack as much as we did in there. Wanted to thank Chris Carlin, Emily Kless, Tracy. You know we love you. Thanks. No worries, bro. And next week we're planning on having Brian Gray from Leaf on. If we get that box of
guaranteed to
Allen and Ginter hobby. We'll have Emily on, and when we open, if we open a second box of masterpieces, we'll make every effort we might as well track down the artist, huh? All right, so I'll put you in charge of that, Ivan.
All right, Dave Palumbo, coming right up. Cool. Let me hit my speed dial.
That's it. Thanks to James Gale behind the scene for keeping all the parts moving correctly. So we will be back next week. Same time, same bat channel, as they say. In the meantime, you know what to be doing. Have a great weekend and always be collecting. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.